वेलकम बैक टू वॉच वीडियोस ऑफ डॉक्टर स्टेला मदी अलहन. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन डे अबाउट एलईसी टेंस वॉर विद चाइना एंड कैन नॉट बी रूल्ड आउट सेड बाय सीडीएस रावत. अमिड्स द ऑनगोइंग मिलिट्री टॉक्स बिटवीन इंडिया एंड चाइना एट सुजल ओवर द डिसएंगेजमेंट at the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh, India's chief of defense staff General Bipin Rawat on 6th November 2020 claimed that situations at the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh remains tense and the possibility of a war with China cannot be ruled out. Further, he stated that the Chinese army is facing unanticipated consequences for its misadventure into Ladakh because of firm responses by Indian forces. The situation along the LAC in eastern Ladakh remains tense and the People's Liberation Army is facing unanticipated consequences for its misadventure in Ladakh because of the firm and strong responses by Indian forces. General Rawat further stated and informed that in the overall security calculus, border confrontations, transgressions, unprovoked tactical military actions spiraling into a larger conflict therefore cannot be discounted. He was speaking at the Diamond Jubilee Webinar 2020 organized by National Defence College in Delhi. Rawat also reiterated that India's posturing is unambiguous and it will not be accept any shift in line of actual control. Regarding the external security challenges facing the nation, Rawat also referred to increasing collusion between Pakistan and China and said it poses an omnipresent danger of regional strategic instability and threatens India's territorial integrity. In that situation, the India and China armies on 6th November held another round of COPS commander level talk with an aim to chart a roadmap for disengagement of troops from all the flashpoints in eastern Ladakh. Government sources said very clearly the 8th round of high level military talk began at 9:30 a.m. to 7 in Suzhal on the Indian side of the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh. He said, in the last few days, the top military brass of India held a series of meetings where the overall situations in eastern Ladakh was reviewed and it was decided to press for comprehensive disengagement of the troops in talks with China. However, India maintained that the disengagement process has to start simultaneously in all the friction points. But there is no proper result reached yet. However, one more talk the military officials ready for very soon. So this is the situation prevailed on the northeastern territory of India. But at the same time, we have the problem with the Sri Lankan problem, especially for the fisher folk. 121 boats, Sri Lankan High Court ordered to dispose all the 121 fisher folk boat which belongs to Tamil fishermen. So they raise a voice and request the central and state government to help the fisher folk to retain all their boats or the compensation by action sale of 121 boats already caught by Sri Lankan Coast Guard. In northwest, Pakistan also endangered our safety on the northwestern part of India. So on all the side, we have to strengthen our army. At the same time, India have all strong army facilities to safeguard India so that we are living in peace and joy inside the nation. In that critical situation, the government announced a new scheme of pension to the military officials. Those who completed 35 years only get the full pension. So it will be definitely discourage the military officials to work for our nation. So it must be reconsidered to strengthen their physical and mental strength of our military people. So the government has to reconsider and help them to work happily. Jai Hind.